Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the One-Stop Co-op Shop. This is Colin, and today we're going to finish up our Alter Quest playthrough. Now, unfortunately, Bairnt has fallen ill, so I'm going to be controlling both Layson and Gwendol, so if we end up losing, we can all blame me. But with that being said, the nice part about doing this in two videos is I got some feedback on the first one. Let's talk about the few things that I missed. First things first, there are four rival cards you need to pull out of the Lurker deck. You will only use those in a specific quest. So I'm going to remove those from the game. I pulled them out of the Lurker deck. The second point is whenever you disarm a trap, you should gain a supply. However, I'm not going to gain a supply because I'm going to offset that with the fact that Loxley, who is an ally, cannot gain or use focus. And I'm sure Bairnt did that a few times. So I'm just not going to gain the supply, but then I'm not going to try and go back and undo all of the focus stuff because that's crazy. Finally, whenever you activate a feature card, it's only a single hero that can activate it. So even though we were both adjacent to the weapons rack, only one of us could activate it. So I'm going to remove one of these points of damages on the Blacksley Sharpshooter because we should have only dealt one damage to it. And then finally, just because I forgot to reroll this die, we'll reroll this die and then start the next round. Here's to hoping for not water. Oh, we've got light. I believe we're going to start off with Gwendol this round. However, Layson's going to go ahead and use the Crescent of the Loon. He's going to use this light symbol to heal one damage and to draw a card, because who doesn't want to draw cards? Let's see, we've got On the Scent. Also, since we're here, let's go ahead and exhaust our Ranger Bow to deal one damage to an enemy within range. We're going to deal one damage to the Werewolf. And remember, that range is 5. We'll then re-roll our 2 Alter Dice, and we get another water. You guys, we have 4 water. But we do have a knight. And you know what? Layson's going to do another thing with the knight here. We're going to use this and flip over to werewolf form. It's going to cause us to take that point of damage we just healed, but all of our cards are for werewolf form, so I really want to get ourselves over to werewolf form. So let's flip all of these. We'll flip this over to our werewolf claws, and this one over to the Crescent of the Loon. Let's then roll this and hope it's not water. Okay, there you go. It's earth. We've done this before with our oak staff here. We'll exhaust that to gain another armor token for Gwendol. Gwendol has an armor token back. She had to use it before. We'll then re-roll this earth, and we have light. I'm just doing all the exhausting I possibly can. We're going to exhaust this card, use that light to gain one focus token. So that means that we now have 2 for Gwendol, 2 focus tokens, which I will take. And we'll have to re-roll this. Let's see. We get wind. We're then going to have Gwendol use her first out of her 3 actions, playing at my command. She's going to attack with her charisma. Her charisma is 2, targeting an enemy that's adjacent to Loxley. Well, that werewolf is adjacent to Loxley. Because it's adjacent to Loxley and within a range of 4, we get to reduce the target's defense by 1. So that means the black wolf will have no defense on this attack, and we'll go ahead and use this wind to deal 1 damage to an enemy adjacent to Loxley. Which will also, well, we could do the werewolf or we could do the crawl assassin. I don't have to decide which one I'm going to do until after we have completed this top action. So let's complete the top action and then we'll decide about who it will affect for the bottom action. We'll roll 2 dice and the alter die that we just used. And we get 1 success and, you know what, I'm going to make it 2. So we can hit him for 2 points of damage. We do have shadow in the alter, which I don't really like. 2 successes though, that means 2 points of damage to the black wolf. For that 1 point of damage, I think we're going to hit the Crawl Assassin. So we'll give him 1 point of damage because he's adjacent to Loxley. He now has 2 out of the 5. Our second action will be this Interact action. We're within range 1 of the weapons rack. We can test our might. Our might is 2. For each supply gained during this test, deal 1 damage to an enemy in this room. I really wanted to show you this because searches are very interesting. So when you search one of these features, you're going to roll dice, and for every success that you get, you're going to cancel out 1 success per the amount of search tokens that are on this feature. So right now for us, that's 0. Then if you have at least 1 or more successes, you get to draw 1 search card. Then any successes beyond that 1, you get to gain supply for the difference. So for example, if I roll 2 successes here, I will be able to draw 1 search card and gain 1 supply. If I somehow get burst and everything and get 3 successes, well, I'll still only get 1 search card, but I'll get 2 supply. So searching is a great way to grab supply. So we're looking for as many successes as we can, but we're only rolling 2 dice. We'll give our 2 dice a roll, and we have 1 success, and we have 1 focus. I think I'll just take the search card and keep the focus to gain a focus token. That will be our second one. This also means we're going to place a search token on that card. So the next time someone searches, they need 2 successes to get a search card, 3 or more to get any supply. So our search card is going to be the Potion of Willpower. This has a use ability. Before rolling dice for your willpower test, gain plus 2 dice for that test. Nice. Our third and final action, we're going to go ahead and interrogate. We're within range 3, 1, 2, 3 of this Kral assassin. We're going to try and have him tell us a little bit of what he knows about Broderick. We'll draw our top card of the interrogation deck, and we have Discern Motive. We're going to test our willpower. Our willpower is 3. For each success, place 1 progress on the advantage in your threat area. And then we're going to place a quest token onto that Kral assassin. So after we beat him up a little bit, we're going to go ahead and try and ask him some questions before we kill him. Love it. I personally feel like this is as good a time as any to go ahead and use this potion. It's a consumable, so I'm going to discard it, but I'm going to roll a total of 5 dice for this. I want as many successes as possible. Let's roll our 5 dice and see what we get. Okay, we have a total of 3 successes here, plus 1 more is 4. We have 2 focus tokens, which I can actually use both the successes here. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 successes plus the 2 that we have on our card. That's a total of 5, 6, 7, and 8. We only need 2 more to complete our source of strength. Well, I certainly like that turn. However, I did forget you guys to change over Layson to werewolf form. There we go. Sorry about that. It is now Layson's turn. First things first, let's exhaust our Lunarian resistance. Use our shadow die here to heal 1 point of damage. I'll take that, so now we only have 1 point of damage on us. I'm really hoping for a fire here. Oh, beautiful, I've got a fire. What I'm going to do with this fire now is use Loxley here. I'm going to exhaust him. This ally may move up to 5 spaces. It's a may, so I don't have to do that. I don't want him to because he's in a perfect space to attack the Kral Assassin. He's going to attack with his might. His might is 2. We're looking for, well, we need 3 successes. That's really not likely with no use of focus tokens, but we can at least do some damage to him. We'll give our 2 dice and that altar die a roll, and we have 2 successes and some light. 2 successes means 2 points of damage. This Kral Assassin is 1 away from being killed. Well, I'm still not sure if this is 100% correct, but with this werewolf coming back in, I'm assuming that we can re-interrogate him. I'm within range 3. So I'm going to go ahead and spend my first action to try and interrogate him. That, of course, will mean I'm placing a quest token on him again. And let's flip over our showdown here. We have test our might. For each success, place 1 progress. Our might is 3 as the Layson Werewolf. I currently have no focus, so it's going to be what I roll. And I have 3 focus that I'm going to gain and 1 success. So that was terrible. That werewolf did not want to talk to another werewolf. Can you blame him? Probably not. But 3 focus is actually kind of nice. I think for my second action, I'm going to do the interact on my weapons rack. And I'm going to see if I can find anything. Now I need at least 2 successes to be successful. Let's see what I can get. And I have 2 successes. So that would mean I'd be successful. I want some supply. So I think I'm going to spend 1. Oh, do I want to spend 2 focus? Because if I spend 2 focus, I have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 would take this out. 2 would give us the success. And 3, 4 would give us 2 supply. And I think I kind of like that. Because that supply we can use to heal ourselves. It can also be used to add additional dice to tests. So I'm going to do that and grab 2 supply. I'm also going to grab, let's see, the Potion of Might. Use before doing your might test, you get plus 2. And yes, a werewolf can use a potion. Of course they can. I then now will place a second search token here. So now it's going to be even harder to search this. And I knew there was a reason why I wanted to gain supply. Because it says, for each supply gained during this test, deal 1 damage to an enemy in this room. You know what that means? We're going to deal 1 damage to this Kral Assassin. This Kral Assassin has 4 damage on it. Boom, 5, he's toast. We're going to gain another supply token. Oh, and that is something I want to mention. Loxley, if it does defeat an enemy, we will still gain the supply token. And from the unofficial FAQ, we can use a supply token to add 1 die to attest that Loxley is doing as well. We've done a total of 2 actions. I'm going to play a feat. This is not an action. On the scent. We're going to test our agility, which is 2 for our werewolf. For each success, move 1 space. Now I wish that we had an earth, but we don't, so I can't do the search. I've got 2 dice. I'm looking for 2 successes here. I have 1 focus, which is perfect because I have 1, and 1 success. We can move 2 spaces. That's not an action, so our third action will be to attack. We'll move 2 spaces, 1, 2, and we're going to go ahead and attack this sharpshooter. We need a total of 3 successes to take him out. He has 1 defense and 2 health remaining. So we're going to attack. We use our might, which is 3 dice. Before rolling, since we'll gain a supply if we defeat this guy, I'm going to go ahead and use a supply so I can roll 4 dice instead of 3. So we're going to roll 4 dice for this attack. Come on, just 3 successes on 4 dice. 1, 2, 3, 4. Beautiful. And 1, 2, 3. We're going to gain 3 focus. That was probably the coolest roll ever. That's what I call an awesome werewolf. And with those 3 successes, we'll have 1 hit the defense, plus the 2 gives us the 5. We'll gain the 1 supply and discard this minion threat. We'll end the hero phase, and of course I forgot to have Gwendol draw a card, so I'm just going to have both of us draw a card now. We've got the Loyal Guardian, which we already have out, and for Layson, we're going to grab the Hunter's Reach. The only threats that are out on the board are the advantage cards, and none of them have activate abilities, so we'll jump right into the villain turn. We have here activate, if the Black Wolf figures on its card, it's not. And then we see here the Black Wolf heals if we had any shadow. That's why I wanted to get rid of any shadow that's in here. We don't have any. We have light and a heck of a lot of water. Then we have, for the Black Wolf here, we have an activate. If it's on this card, it's not. Once again, it would use the shadow to actually do a resist effect. Now, just so you know, resist also goes through anybody's shield or armor tokens. So resists are pretty terrible because you can't stop that with any of your defense. But since there's no shadow in the altar pool, we don't have to worry about that. Let's go ahead and draw our top card. We are going to have to deal with this one. We have the Alpha Wolf. No, he's not the Alpha Wolf. I am. If the Black Wolf figure is on the board, each hero must either discard 1 card or draw 1 Lurker card. Oh, I hate to say it, but that's an easy solution of each of us discarding a card. I'm in wolf form, can't use Hunter's Reach anyways, and Loyal Guardian, we already have that out on the table, so yeah, we're going to discard each one of these, but that means Bairnt has no cards in hand. Next, we have our quest turn, and this states each hero with an advantage card in their threat area must either discard 1 progress from it or discard 1 card. Well, Bairnt has no cards, so he's going to have to discard a progress. I only have 2 progress on mine, I'm just going to discard 1 progress. I like my cards too much. Then we have the Burning Altar. Each hero may suffer 1 damage to change 1 altar die to a result of their choice. And with all that water in there, I'm going to do it. So I'm going to have each of us suffer 1 damage. Now I just have to figure out what do I want to change them to. Let's change 1 to a shadow because we know we can use that as the wolf. Where are you, shadow? Where are you, shadow? There you are. And then we'll do 1 for fire because that's going to allow Loxley to attack. So we'll do 1 of each of those. Perfect. Next, we do have the fungal patch, but I'm not even showing it because it's not going to activate. Finally, we have the weapons rack. We still have Gwendol next to it, so a hero adjacent to this may deal 1 damage to an enemy that's in the room. Well, the only enemy that's still in the room is the Black Wolf. He will now have 4 points of damage. We chucked another axe at him. With that, I think we're ready to start the next turn. So first things first, for this turn, let's go ahead and start again with Gwendol. We'll start by activating our Loyal Guardian again, exhausting it to gain 1 focus. I love that. We're also going to exhaust Loxley. We're not going to move, but we're going to attack. We're going to attack that Black Werewolf, rolling 2 dice. Our might is only 2, and he has 1 armor. Maybe that's not the greatest thing. I could instead move up to 5 spaces. You know what? I have an idea. Let's go ahead and move up to 5 spaces, and then let's see if we get in range of an enemy that we can attack. Remember, our range is 1. First, let's reroll this die, and we have a light. Well, if you look at this room over here, enemies are going to spawn here. I think what I'm going to do is have Loxley, because this guy, he's just going to keep coming out, and he's not helping us progress to actually defeat the boss, even though he technically is the boss. What I'm going to do is have her turn tail and run. 1, 2, 3, 4, and she's going to go ahead and unlock a door, because that seems to be what she does. So let's do that and see what we get. Let's flip our feature card. I think we know what this is. It's the altar. Yes, the altar has been found. This is part 1 of 2 parts that we needed to complete to win this game. We needed to find the altar, and then we needed to defeat the villain. Next, we'll flip our quest card, and we have On the Right Track. As you carefully open the door, you hear a sudden rustling beyond and the slam of a door. Looking inside, you can see the signs of a hasty exit. You must be close. There's no time to lose if your foe truly had you at the advantage. Why would they run? The urgency gives you a sense of hope that you're not falling into a trap, but catching your foe where you want them, scared. If a hero has an advantage card in their threat area, look at the bottom 2 cards of the feature deck. I think we just did this. It's the same thing. You can choose to place 1 on top and 1 on the bottom. Otherwise, you may discard the top card of the villain deck. Ooh. We've found the feature that we need. Let's go ahead and just discard the top card of the villain deck. It's going to make him come out a little bit faster. So Stalker of the Swales has been discarded. That means he only has four more cards until he is going to come out. Next, let's go ahead and draw our threat cards. This first one is for Bairnt. We have the Blacksley Sharpshooter again. This one is blue. Once again, it's going to come out with three threat tokens, and I did not think about that. Dang it. So even if Loxley gets in range of these guys, they're going to be impossible to hit with three defense. This one will be the blue minion, and then this one will be mine. Is it going to be an enemy? Yes, it is. It's going to be a Shadowbender. This is a new one. It will come in. It's a yellow one. It'll also come with three threat tokens. Forgot to show you, I've got my three threat tokens for the sharpshooter as well. The blue sharpshooter spawned first, so we'll place him here. And then the yellow Shadowbender is going to be placed here. Now Loxley has one more move, and remember, we have to move to this adjacent space right here. Do note though that I could stand here and attack over here. I just cannot move that way. This is only adjacent for movement. This is still diagonally adjacent for attacking. So you could be at this part of the door attacking this space. It's kind of weird, just something you have to note. I have other uses for the fire, so I'm not going to use that for Loxley's attack because that's going to just hit nothing. Instead, I think I'm going to do something else. Gwendol's going to spend her first action to move. She's going to move 1, 2, 3. She's going to move back here. So she's out of range, but she is within range of doing an interact. She's going to do her second action as an interact action and try and interrogate this blasted minion here, this Shadowbender, and maybe, just maybe, get three successes and complete their his advantage card. Here's to hoping it's a good one. We'll flip this over. It's Perilous Ploy. You may suffer any amount of damage. For each damage suffered, place one progress on the advantage. Yes, we're going to take the chance. So right now, Gwendol has 2 damage on her. She's going to suffer 3, which will give her a total of 5 damage, 5 out of the 10. But you know what that means? That will be the 3 progress we need for the Source of Strength. The Source of Strength has now had enough progress placed on it. We're placing 3 more on it. We're going to destroy it. Great. Bairnt doesn't have anything great to do for his final action. He's just going to use his final action to draw a card. So he's going to draw Primal Coordination. With that, he's then going to end his turn by drawing another card. He'll have Lay of the Land, but what's nice is he's finally getting a hand of cards. He now has 2. I get all excited, you guys. I forgot to place a quest token onto the Shadowbender, notating that we have interrogated him, so we can't do that again. Moving to Layson's activation, this is going to be far from ideal, but I'm not sure what else I can do. Kind of put myself into this predicament. I had him set up to open this room right over here, but instead I decided to have Loxley open a room. So what I'm going to have to do is spend 2 actions for him, because he's going to have to go 1, 2, 3, and this is to move, 4, 5 to come over here. Now the reason for that is because he could have moved here and attacked the Shadowbender, but he wants to use his focus that he has right now to get rid of those threat tokens. You can only do that for enemies that are in your room. This is not in this room, so he cannot do that. He had to actually move to get himself into that room. So now he's in that room. He's spent 2 actions. Let's have some fun. This Shadowbender has a total of 6 health. He's kind of the worst one, so I am going to discard all 3 of my focus tokens to get rid of all 3 threat tokens. That means he has no defense. Then for my third action, I'm going to use my Wolf Claws here. I'm going to use this final action to do this, attacking with 3 dice, and then I'm going to go ahead and use this Shadow. After rolling dice for your attack, add 1 burst to the results. I'm assuming I'm going to need that to get 6 successes. If I somehow get 6 with this attack, I won't use that die for this. Here's the start of our attack. We'll roll these 3. We have 1, 2 successes and 2 focus. I am going to use this then for sure to get ourselves a burst over here. And then we get to roll another die as well as that alter die. We'll give them a roll. Ugh. Okay, I didn't keep any focus, so I only have 1, 2, 3 successes. He'll be at half health, but I've gained 3 focus. 1, 2, 3. However, I am going to play my Tearing Fangs. Play this card immediately after resolving the action on Wolf Claws. You may suffer 1 damage, so that will give me a 3rd point of damage out of 12 to be able to attack again with our strength, or our might, which is 3. And then I'm going to use this to deal 1 damage to an enemy that's in range as long as I need to. So if this doesn't defeat him, an enemy within range would be the Shadowbender, so that should be able to take him out, no problem. He's already at half health. I just need two successes here. I've got two. I'll go ahead and gain another focus for number four. So that's two damage plus the three. That's five. We'll use this to do the sixth point of damage. So that will take him out. We'll roll this. We've got another earth. So we've got two earth now, a light and two water. We're going to gain another supply because we just defeated an enemy. I have four supply. That's pretty sweet. Now, something to note, I have another Tearing Fangs in my hand, but I can't use that a second time. You can only use it one time per action window. So per time when you can play a reaction, you can play one reaction. I can't play seven reactions at a time when I can play one of them, if that makes sense. That'll end my turn. I'm pretty happy with my four focus because I can use that to help us get rid of that sharpshooter. I'm going to go ahead and draw a card, and we have Spot Weakness. And now let's go ahead and move to the threat turn. The only threat we have is this Blaxley Sharpshooter. It has that range of 5, can move up to 4. It's going to do an engage and then an inflict of 5. And there is no shadow in the pool, just so you can see. This is what our altar pool looks like. We've got water, light, and earth. Technically, both Loxley and Layson are within range 2. So we're going to have him choose Loxley to attack. He can get within range 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and he can move 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's go ahead and move him here, and that way he can go ahead and shoot Loxley. Loxley's agility is 2, and remember, we cannot use any focus, but Loxley does have 1 defense. So let's roll. It'd be nice if I rolled this in here. So we have 1, 2 successes. Gosh, Loxley is great. That's a burst. 3 successes plus the defense of 1. So... out of a 5 damage attack, he only gets it for 1 damage. He has 4 damage on him. He still has 2 health left. Bring it! We'll move to the villain's turn. This one has no effect. This one has no effect. There's no shadow. So no shadow in the altar pool. So we'll go ahead and just draw a card. And we have, if the black wolf figure is on the board, it must engage and inflict 6. Ooh! It can move a total of 6. And you know it's going to go towards Loxley. He's going to come up from behind, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and attack Loxley right here through the door. Loxley's fortitude is 3, so let's give these a roll. And we have 1, 2, 3 successes with a burst. My goodness. Let's roll that up. 4. 4 successes, 1, 2, 3, 4, plus the armor is 5. Once again, that awesome cat. You know, I'm more of a dog person, but I have to say, this is a 5. We should only have 1 damage. I have to say, I'm impressed with this cat. So this cat still has 1 health left. Finally, we'll move to the quest turn. Each hero with an advantage card in their threat area, that is only me, must either discard 1 progress or 1 card. I think it's safe to say we'll get rid of Spot Weakness. I mean, I like the card, but I think I'm going to stay in werewolf form, so I might as well. And that 1 progress is really helping me here. and, you know, Bairnt doesn't have any. He's taking care of his. He's saying, Colin, what the heck are you doing? Then we have each hero may suffer 1 damage to change 1 alter die to a result of their choice. I think I'm going to have Layson do that. So he's going to take 1 damage. And let's go ahead and change one of these water symbols. And we're going to change that to a shadow symbol. I think that's probably the best bet. We'll use that to do some pretty awesome attacking with Layson. Now though, each hero in the altar's room may deal 1 damage to an enemy in their room. And it says here each hero, not any hero. So we each get to do this. So I'll go ahead and deal 2 damage to that sharpshooter. He only has 3 health left. I'll take that. There's still no fire in the altar pool, so we can ignore that. Let's go ahead and move to the next turn. Layson's going to start us off for this round. We're going to discard 3 focus tokens and remove all 3 threat tokens from that sharpshooter. Now before we annihilate him with our claws, let's go ahead and interrogate him, because he is within range 3. This will be our first of 3 actions to do this. And we get Clever Trap. Yes, a werewolf and a Clever Trap. We're going to be testing our agility for this. Our agility is 2. We're definitely going to discard 1 of our supplies. We can roll 3 dice for this. We do still have 1 focus left as well. And don't forget, we have to place a quest token on that sharpshooter so we can't interrogate him again. 3 dice, looking for bursts. We've got 1 burst and 2 focus. That's somewhat of a terrible roll. Let's roll this. Okay, we've got 1, 2... And I'm going to make it 3 successes plus the 1 that we have on there. That gives us a total of 4. And we're just going to gain this focus back with this die roll. I still need a total of 6 progress on this card. Man, that's a lot. Action 2. Let's go ahead and move 1, 2. And let's open this door first. Loxley isn't the only one that gets to open doors. We'll open a door once in a while. And let's reveal what we found. Let's start with our feature card. So we'll flip this one. We have a cauldron. So we can activate this during the quest phase. A hero adjacent to this feature may place one search token on this card to gain one discarded consumable search card. Ooh, we already have one in the discard. We can also interact and do a wisdom search, which is great for Gwendol. Her wisdom is 3. Then you may reveal the top 3 cards of the search deck. Discard one revealed consumable card and shuffle the rest back into the deck. Cool. We'll place that awesome looking cauldron right here. I love that mini. It looks so cool. We'll now flip our quest card and we have living quarters. The door opens to what is obviously used to be a living quarters by your sworn enemy. Must have been cooking something. The various oddments that occupy this space leave no doubt in your mind. This is where you are sure to learn what you need to know about the enemy's ability to survive through mortal peril. After an initial assessment of the quarters, you can tell there's plenty to discern from closer inspection, if you had the time. We're going to attach this to this room's feature card. A hero adjacent to this feature may discard this card to either place 2 progress on the unnatural protection or discard the top card of the villain deck. Yeah, the one that I have is the unnatural protection. That is awesome. So if we can have Lacing gets next to this, oh, that's really cool, then we can actually put 2 more progress on it. Finally, we'll draw our threat cards, starting with Lacing. So Lacing gets from the shadows. Each minion threat with 2 or more threat tokens immediately activates. No, we just got rid of the threat tokens from our sharpshooter, so that's not going to happen. If no minion threat activates this way, each hero must either discard 1 focus or suffer 1 damage. Well, Gwendol will definitely discard 1 focus, and you know what? So will Lacing. Lacing has 1 focus. Let's discard. We're each at 4 and 5 damage, respectively. I don't want to deal with that. Okay, bummer. That was my card. This one will be Gwendol's card. Gwendol will get another Crawl Assassin, a blue one. That, of course, will come in with 3 threat tokens. That Crawl Assassin will spawn right here. Lacing still has 2 more actions, and I think what I'm going to plan on doing is taking out that Crawl Assassin, then moving 1, 2, 3, getting adjacent to this, so we can get 2 more progress on our interrogation card or advantage card. That would be pretty gosh darn awesome. So let's go ahead and for action 2, we're going to attack that sharpshooter. The sharpshooter only has 3 health, so I'm feeling pretty good about this. We have 1, 2 successes and 2 focus. That's not going to be enough. Yeah, but you know what will be. So we'll go ahead and gain 2 focus for that. And we've dealt 2 more points of damage. And I will take 2 back of focus because we don't have any. But then we'll use, perfect, we'll exhaust our wolf claws. Use the earth here to deal 1 damage to an enemy within range. Our range is 1. We totally just took out that crawl assassin. Oh, that's the, not assassin, the sharpshooter, my apologies. And that will gain us another supply. We have a total of 4 supply. I feel pretty good about that. And then we'll go ahead and re-roll this die. And we get another light. So now we've got 2 light in the pool. Then I think I'm going to exhaust my Lunarian resistance here. And I'm going to heal 1 damage. So I had 4. Now I only have 3 damage. And I'm going to have to use the shadow for that. So I'm going to use that. Let's give that a roll. Come on, be a wind. Oh my gosh, it's a wind. That's amazing. That was what I was hoping for. So that means I'll wait on this. I could reroll up to 2 altar dice. But I don't think I want to reroll any right now. I could do that later if we need. So after we remove this dead carcass from the board, we'll have our werewolf, Lacing, move 1, because remember that's only adjacent for movement from the door, 2, and then 3. And of course we'll knock the door over, which makes sense. Moving to Gwendol's turn, she's going to be a bit of an Elder Pool hog. She's going to use Earth here and exhaust her Oak Staff to gain 1 armor token. That's her second one. She's going to exhaust the Loyal Guardian and use the Light here to gain 1 focus. That's good because she has no focus right now, so that'll give her 1. And then she's going to use the Wind here for you and Loxley may each heal 1 damage. So she's going to go from 5 damage down to 4, and that's going to be the same thing with Loxley. Loxley had 5, now he'll have 4. If he was not on the board, he could then spawn from that, but he is on the board, so we don't have to worry about that part. We'll then go ahead and grab these 3 and re-roll them to see what we get. And we have Wind and 2 more Earth. Isn't that just what I used? No, I had a light in there. For our first action, then, I think we're going to use Primal Coordination. You may move up to 2 spaces and attack with Agility. Her Agility is 2. Then Loxley can attack with Fortitude, and his Fortitude is 3, targeting an enemy that's adjacent to him. Then we can use Water to have Loxley or you move 2 spaces. I don't know if I'm going to do that yet. remember what I said. You can attack from a diagonal through the door. You just can't move. So she's going to move to right here. That means we're both going to be able to attack this werewolf. This first attack of two dice can use focus, and I am going to use one supply to actually make it three. So we're going to roll three dice for this. We need to get through one armor. He's got six health left. Let's give him a roll. We have two successes and two focus. Two successes is only 1 point of damage. I think what I'll do is I'll use one focus and then I'll gain that back. So one, two, three total successes gives us a total of 2 points of damage. He'll go from four damage to six, only four health left. We then will pick this up. We cannot use that. Loxley, it's just going to be what we roll, but he does get to roll three dice. I could use a supply for four. Ooh, is that tempting? I've got three. You know, no, because we can't use focus for it. Let's just roll three. Yeah, let's just roll three dice. We have one, two, three successes. He's the best attacker ever with a burst. What the heck is that? That is, I'm just going to reroll that one. let's see. That's another success. So we have one, two, three, four successes. He has one armor. We just dealt him three damage. Oh, that puts him down to nine. You guys, he has nine damage out of 10. You know what? With that, I think I'm going to use this water to have me or Loxley move up to two spaces. We have to roll that die, and we get an earth. I'm going to go ahead and have Loxley run. We're going to have him move one, two, start moving towards the next room. Because I think for our second action, we're just going to do a regular attack. We only need to do 1 point of damage, and even though this card is exhausted, we can still do the action. We're going to attack with our might. So we're rolling two dice. We just need two successes to take him out. Let's give him a roll. We've got a burst there. Let's see if we can get any focus. That's another burst. Come on, focus. There's a focus. So we'll gain one focus. We totally annihilated that werewolf. We just bonked him on the head with an oak staff. I love it. I should mention that will give us back our fourth supply as well. So now we have four supply. We'll remove the mini from the board and put it back onto that card. I know there's a wind in the altar pool, which means that Gwendol will be able to summon Loxley back out. So I think it makes the most sense to now exhaust Loxley. I was really hoping to have a fire so we could have him attack at least, but we're just going to exhaust him to have him move five spaces. We'll have him move one, two, three, four, just to get right up into this Crawl Assassin's face. And then for the third action for Gwendol, one, two, three, she's just going to move right behind the door to start trying to catch up with Layson. And of course, as usual, I forgot to draw a card for Layson, so let's go ahead and draw a card for Layson and for Gwendol now. We're going to end our activations. Layson is going to draw Lose the Scent, and we have for Gwendol, Gwendol will draw the Mystical Link. Moving to the threat turn, the only threat we have to deal with is the Crawl Assassin. We have Engage. He's already engaged with Loxley, so he won't move. He's going to attack with Might as Loxley's defense. He only rolls two dice. No if unable, and no shadow in the altar pool, just so you can see what the altar pool looks like. We've got three earth, we have a wind, and we have a light. Can Loxley survive this attack? Let's see. We'll roll two dice. That's a burst. Did you see that die? I love it. Let's see. We'll roll. That's a total of three successes, you guys, plus one defense. That's four. And he has only will take 1 point of damage. That puts him back to 5 points of damage. But that loyal cat is still around. This is amazing. During the villain turn, we have if the wolf figures on its card, it's going to heal two damage. And then it's going to heal two more damage from this one. We have no shadow in the altar pool, so we don't have to worry about that. We only have three cards left in the villain deck. Let's go ahead and reveal this one. If the black wolf is on the board, it's not. Otherwise, this is going to heal two damage. And then if it has no damage, it's going to spawn. No, it'll still have four damage. So I'll place four damage here. And that will end our villain turn. We'll then move to the quest turn, each hero with an advantage. I'm going to be the only one that has that, so I'll discard Lose the Scent. I'm just going to stay in werewolf form for a while. We have our Burning Altar. Each hero may suffer one damage to change one altar die. There are three earth altar dice, but I can use... Yeah, I'm going to do it. I'm going to have Layson suffer one damage to turn this into a shadow, just because we can do lots of cool stuff with that. So I'll take 1 point of damage for that. That gives Layson a total of four, but heck, I can even heal with that if I need to. And then, let's see, it says here, each hero in the altar's room may deal one damage to an enemy in their room. There isn't any. There's no fire, so we can't do that. Now we have the cauldron. A hero adjacent to this feature may place one search token on this card to gain one discarded consumable search card. Why the heck not? Let's do it. We'll place a search token there. We're going to grab the Potion of Willpower. That's the only one that will have to be with Layson, because Layson's the one that's next to it. And then we have here, a hero adjacent to this feature may discard this card to either place two progress on unnatural protection. That's definitely what I'm doing. That will place number 5 and 6. I only need 4 more. Of course, then I'll have to discard this card, and I will do that right now. Let's now move back to our hero turn. I think the first thing we're going to do is use our Lunarian Resistance here. We're going to use it, heal 3 damage, and gain 1 focus. So we had 4 damage. We're now going to remove 3 of them, so we only have 1. And we're going to gain our third focus, which is great. But that means since we're using it, we're going to have to discard this card. We're then going to spend action 1, 1, 2, 3, moving right up to here. And we're ready to take on that Kral Assassin. Of course, before doing that, we are going to spend our second action to interrogate him. So we're going to draw our final showdown card. I'm assuming that when this is empty, we'll reshuffle. Normally, quest cards you don't reshuffle, but I'm assuming with these ones you do. We have a diplomatic approach. Really, a diplomatic approach? That's not Layson's way. we're going to test charisma, which is 1. For each success, we place 1 token on here. I'm definitely going to use a supply, so at least we can roll 2 dice. We've got 3 supply left. Well, I was kind of hoping that we could do it here, but there's pretty much no chance. 2 dice. Let's see what we get. We have 1. Oh, we are actually really close. I am going to use a focus. So that gives us 1, 2, 3 successes here. We're 1 away. We're at 9. We're then going to use our remaining 2 focus that we have here and use our once per turn ability to remove both of these threats. So this Kral Assassin has 1 defense. Then let's go ahead and have a little bit of fun. We're going to exhaust this, deal 1 damage to an enemy within range. Yeah, he's within range. So that will deal him 1 point of damage. He now has 4 health left. We're also going to use this die just because I know we're going to need it for the burst. And we're going to do the attack rolling 3 dice. We'll roll our 3 dice, and the 1 altar die we for sure are going to use or already used. We've got 1 success and 2 focus. Let's go ahead and then definitely use this to gain the burst symbol. And that means we get to roll in another die. Let's see. We get another success. And of course, I have to reroll this one in. Okay, we've got a fire. Oh, beautiful. With this attack, I'm dealing a total of 1, 2, 3 points of damage. He has 1 armor, so I'm dealing him 2 actual points of damage, plus the 1 from before, so he has 3 damage out of his 5. I will also gain 1, 2, 3 focus. I love this game. I love how the focus works. It's so fun. Even when you miss, you get something good for it, because you know what we're going to do. It's in our hand. We're going to tear him apart. Or I could let someone like Loxley take him on. This is the werewolf. He's going to do it. We're going to take 1 point of damage for this. So that will give us our second point of damage. But with our tearing fangs, we're going to roll 3 more dice. 1, 2, 3. Let's see if we can kill him. If we can't, we can always use that fire we just rolled to take him out. So let's see. We have 1, 2, 3 successes plus this one, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 successes. Minus 1 for his armor. That's 3 more hits, plus the 3 damage on him. He's gone. We'll gain 1 supply, and that's going to end our activation. Let's remove this dead carcass from the board as we took it out. Let's now, let's see. I think we're going to exhaust Loxley, because Loxley can move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Enemies are going to be coming in from here, but Loxley could at least block them. Yeah. So let's go ahead and have Loxley open a door. We'll exhaust Loxley to do this. And remember, we do have a fire now that's here in the pool. So if we do happen to get an enemy in range, we can also attack with his strength. I really just need to find 1 more minion so I can get rid of that advantage card. 1, 2, 3. Let's open up this door and see what we find. We'll flip our card here. In our feature, we have a crate. A hero adjacent to this feature may gain 1 supply. Ooh, that's nice. Interact, you can do a search here. So let's place that out on the board. Too bad those crates are going to be so far away from the door. They're going to be placed all the way over here. Let's go ahead and draw a quest card, and we have Uncertain Followers. Several individuals reside in this room, surprised by your sudden appearance. Wait, one of them calls out, either to distract you or appeal to your compassion. Regardless, you indeed hesitate. Unsure of their true intentions, you approach cautiously, waiting to see whose side they are on. Something tells you they don't truly have a side and are merely opportunists who follow the path of least resistance. Renvealed. Each hero with an advantage card in their threat area, so that's me, must either discard one progress from it or resist. Do a resist of 4 for willpower. Our willpower is 2. Each hero with no advantage card, that's Bairnt, in their threat area may test charisma 3. His charisma is 2. Each hero who passes may heal 2 damage. Oh, each hero who fails must draw 1 lurker card. Yeah, I think I'm gonna try that. I've got some focus. I'll roll 2 dice. First, let's do Layson's willpower test of 4. I am going to discard the potion of willpower. So instead of only rolling 2 dice, I'm rolling 4. Now this goes through any armor. So any non-successes up to that 4, I'm going to take his damage. I'll roll these up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Beautiful. 4 successes. I'm good to go. No problem. Now the charisma test. We're only going to roll 2 dice. There's nothing I can do to add to that. So I need 3 successes. If I fail, I draw a lurker card. Let's see what I get. I get 2 successes. I don't think there's anything I can do about that. This means we're going to have our first lurker card. Not that I really want this. And also, I'm going to apologize. None of these lurkers are going to be painted. It is what it is. Well, I shouldn't say that. The ones that I painted are these sets. There are sets of Crawl Assassins and Sharpshooters in here. But yeah, this one isn't. The Maria Melatonite. Wow, that's a crazy name. It's going to have an activate. It inflicts 5. Fortitude is defense. I'm going to go ahead and put that into Gwendol's threat area. Not going to lie, these guys look awesome. Oh, yeah, they'll look even cooler painted. Haven't gotten there, but yeah, I'm going to spawn them here. Now we're going to draw our 2 threat cards. Our first one will be for Bairnt, and he gets a Kral Decoy, so that's another trap. We know what those look like. And then our next one will be a green sharpshooter. That one's for me. We'll place the trap right here as close as it can be to any of our characters, and then this sharpshooter will go probably right here. We've completed revealing the room. Loxley has 2 more movement. Remember, we don't want to go within range 1 of this guy or he's going to trigger and he's going to activate that sharpshooter. Oh, and that sharpshooter should have 3 threat tokens on it. I'll do that. But so Loxley's going to come out for 5 right here. I think it's safe to say we're spread a little bit thin. Gwendol's going to spend her first action to move. She's going to move 1, 2, 3. Move adjacent to this. Her second action, she's going to play a card. She's going to go ahead and do a search action here. Then you or Loxley may move up to 2 spaces. She's also going to use an earth here to go ahead and draw a card. I'm going to do that now just so I don't forget. She's going to get Faithful Companion. The cauldron needs 2 successes to gain a search card. Any successes above 2, she'll gain supply. She'll roll this up. She's got 3 successes, so that's going to give her 1 supply. And we're going to place another search token onto the cauldron. So the cauldron now has 2 search tokens. And we're going to grab a search card. And our search card will be a Blinding Powder. We can use this, exhaust a minion within range. Whoa, within range 5. Or exhaust before rolling dice for your inflict test from an enemy within range. Add 1 to your defense value for that test. Cool. We then get to either move Loxley or ourselves 2 spaces. We're definitely going to move 2 spaces. Let's then go ahead and exhaust our loyal guardian here. We're going to use this light die to gain a focus. That will give us a total of 3 focus tokens. I'm realizing I forgot to roll in that earth die, so I'm going to reroll both of these. Oh, we have a shadow and a light. Can we use that shadow? For my third and final action, I think I'm just going to run in here. 1, 2, 3. Move over here. I have not triggered the trap. We haven't moved within range 1. And then I'm going to go ahead and use this blinding powder. I'm going to use the use effect here. Exhaust a minion within range. It's range 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to go ahead and exhaust that huge looking Bray. When you exhaust a minion, when the threats activate, he will not activate because of that. We basically threw blinding powder in his face. Finally, we're going to discard all 3 focus that we have to remove all 3 threat tokens from that sharpshooter because we're in the same room. That's the other reason I wanted to go there. Unfortunately, during the threat phase, this blasted thing is going to keep adding threat tokens to that guy. That's why I wanted to get rid of the 3, so I'll only have 1 to deal with instead of 4. That's going to end our activations, and one of these days I'm going to remember to actually draw our cards right at the end of our players' turns. We have Lose the Scent and Nature's Fury. Let's then now move to the threat phase, and let's activate the threats in front of me first. This sharpshooter is going to activate. It's going to attack with the agility as defense on Loxley. I don't think it's going to move because it's only going to get closer to us if it tries to move here. It's within range. It's just going to simply stay there and attack Loxley. How many lives does Loxley have? Let's see. We're rolling two dice. His agility is two, and he gets only one success. So that means he got hit for four damage. He has one armor, so he'll take three damage. He already has five damage on him. Yeah, he's finally removed from the board. But I would say Loxley has been amazing so far. That'll activate the threats in front of me. Now let's have the trap activate. And all the trap is going to do is it states each minion threat in this room gains one threat token. Not regular minions, so this lurker will not. Only minions that are threats. This one is a threat minion, so that one will gain one threat token. Oh, and you guys, I missed this. We have a shadow alter die. It's going to also gain another threat token. Golly, it's going to have two. And deal one damage to a character within range. Well, Loxley was taken out with the attack, so that's going to be Gwendol. Gwendol's going to go to having 5 points of damage instead of four. Ow. Now let's reroll this. We'll give it a roll, and it's a fire. Next, we have our two regular activates here. We're going to remove all four of the damage. This werewolf is ready to go. I'm going to remove this quest token based on how I was playing it. We're going to draw. We only have one more card after this. We have, if this figure's on the board, it's not. Otherwise, it heals 1 HP, and then it's going to spawn in the revealed room with the most characters. So there's one character in each room, so I think then we get to decide. Our werewolf is really far away. That's not good, but I still think I'm going to put him in this room just because if I put him in that room, I'd have to leave my werewolf over there and our poor druid would have to deal with two minions here on her own. This way, our werewolf can run in here. We can get Loxley back out, hopefully, and then we'll have three against three. The only two cards in the quest area that will activate is the showdown card here and the burning altar. Each hero with an advantage card must either discard one progress from it or discard one card. I'm just going to discard one progress. We've got tons of minions. I have 5, 6, 7, 8 progress still on it. I feel good about that. Then here, each hero may suffer one damage to change one altar die. I don't think I'm going to do that. Then each hero in the altar's room can't do that, but there is a fire. Each figure must either discard one armor token or suffer one damage. So Gwendol has two armor, so she's going to discard one of those. Loxley's not on the board. We don't have to worry about that. Layson is going to take 1 point of damage. And then the sharpshooter, the Bray, and the Black Wolf will all take 1 point of damage. So actually, I'll take that. I took one damage. They took three. Then let's reroll this die. Let's see what we get. And we get a shadow. Ooh. Let's go ahead and have Layson go first. We're going to have Layson spend two of his three actions moving. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and getting adjacent to this trap. But by doing that, the trap is going to be triggered. With a triggered trap, we either have to discard one focus or activate a minion threat. We'll discard one focus, no problem. We then are going to use a light that we have in our altar pool here to gain a focus and actually flip over to archer form. This means we'll go back to having three focus again. It also means now we can attack range, which is nice because we're at a range from all of those minions. We're also going to exhaust Gwendol and the Loyal Guardian here. Gwendol, and using the wind, to you and Loxley may each heal one damage. So she'll go down to four damage instead of five. Then if Loxley's figure is on its ally card, place that figure in the space adjacent to your figure. So we'll do that. Also, we're just going to gain one focus token with this light. So that means I'm going to reroll three of these altered dice. We're essentially just hoping for not shadow, and we get a shadow, of course. We're going to place Loxley right here, and we're going to change over Layson to archer form. For our third and final action, we're going to try and task against this trap and take it out. Layson's intellect is only 2. However, we're going to use a supply so we can roll 3 dice for this. We're also going to play the Faithful Companion card as a reaction from Gwendol. Play this card before a hero adjacent to Loxley rolls dice for a test. That hero gains +1 die to their test. So we're going to roll 4 dice then for this. And then each hero, because we're going to use the fire here, each hero adjacent to Loxley gains 1 armor token. That will be both Gwendol and Layson. We're looking for 4 successes on 4 dice. I think that's doable. We've got 1, 2, 3. We can use a focus here because I've got focus for 4 and then gain a focus back from here. So we're still having 3 focus and we're going to gain another supply because we just eliminated that trap. So that gives us a total of 5 supply. Sweet. And we've got some more fire in our altar pool. That'll end Layson's activation and we'll remove this trap from the board. Oh, wait, we're going to do one more thing. We're going to use two focus here to remove the two threat that's on this sharpshooter. And by the way, we've been saying this wrong the whole time. It's Black Sky. I don't know what the Black's cleave. Where's the L? I don't know. Black Sky sharpshooter. That's way cooler. Moving to Gwendol's turn, let's go ahead and use Loxley. We're going to exhaust Loxley to go ahead and have him move five spaces. Use our fire here. He's going to attack for two with his might. Our goal here is simple. We don't want all three of these minions to activate or we're going to die. One, two, three. Loxley's going to run into here and he's going to go ahead and attack that sharpshooter since he has no armor and four health remaining. I think with this attack, we're going to use a supply for it. So we get to roll three dice for the attack instead of only two. Three dice and one alter die, just looking for hits, looking for hits. We've got two bursts, so we can roll two more of these in. We have one, two, three, four, five total hits. The focus is useless. We have wind now, which is amazing. Yeah, that black sky sharpshooter is toast. That's going to give us our supply right back. Loxley, what a bite. I'm telling you, the MVP of this game has been that cat. That wasn't even an action. Okay, what do we want to do for our first action now? Well, I think I know what I'm going to start with. I'm going to start with using our ranger bow here, exhaust it, use the wind that we just rolled in to deal one damage to that Bray. That Bray now has 2 points of damage on it. He only has three health remaining. The two armor is a little bit scary, but I'll still take that. Let's give our die a roll and we get some more fire. Let's do our first action as Nature's Fury. We can attack within a range of four using our willpower. Our willpower is three. Then if Loxley is within range, change one alter die to a result of our choice. We're going to change one of these shadow ones over to, let's make it an earth because I can do things with earth. So we'll change it to earth, especially because I can use this actually. But yeah, let's do that because he's definitely going to be within range. The range of that attack is four. One, two, three, four. We're going to hit that Bray. We're going to use a supply for this, so we get to roll four dice. We have one focus. This guy's got two armor, so this is going to be interesting. Let's see how much we can do. Well, we hit him for a whopping one damage. One, two, three. That will deal him 1 point of damage. We could gain... Oh, you know what? Actually, I'm going to use one of the focus as another success. We have one, two, three, four, and I'm going to gain this back. That means we did a total of two damage to him. That means he has a total of four damage on him. And then we can use this earth, deal one damage to an enemy within range. Beautiful. We'll do that to the Bray. The Bray will then be taken down. We'll get our supply back and we'll remove him from the board. And we don't have to worry about an inflict five. Ugh. Let's then also quickly reroll this die up and we have earth again. That means we're only going to have to deal with the werewolf during the enemy activation. So I'll take that. For our second action, let's go ahead and run over to the crates so we're adjacent to them. And action three, we're going to interact with them. We can do an interact using our intellect, which is one. Then, so we can do that search. Then you may discard one supply to draw one card. Well, I'm going to use a supply for this, so our search will be two dice. Hopefully that'll help us out a little bit. We'll roll up our two dice, and we get two successes. We could have three, but I think instead I'll just gain a second focus token. So I'll have two focus tokens. With this one success, we'll place one search token here and we get to draw a search card. And for our second success here, we're going to get our supply back that we used. So we have a total of five supply. So our search card that we have is a potion of healing. Choose a character within range to heal three damage. Wow, I'm going to probably just use that on myself because they're going to have four damage on me. And then what we can do is we can discard a supply here to draw one search card. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to go back down to only having four supply and I'm going to draw another search card. And this one is a discarded pack. Gain two supply, then discard this card. Awesome. So that's going to give us a total of six supply. I'm then going to use our oak staff here, and I'm going to use this earth to gain another armor token. I'll then reroll that die, and I get a light. I'm then going to immediately use that light and exhaust it to heal one damage for Lacen here and draw one card. That's what I really wanted to do is get... we have spot weakness. And then we'll reroll that die up, and we have more light. I'm then going to end the hero phase, and I keep forgetting to have Lacen draw a card when they ended his turn. We've got the elusive Grace over here, and for Gwendol, she has at my command. We'll move directly into the villain phase because there's no threats out on the board. This has an activate, which won't happen because it's not on its card, but we do have Shadow. The wolf is going to heal, so we'll heal up the wolf to full and reroll this. Don't be a shadow, don't be a shadow. Okay, it's water. We've completed activating this card. This one says, if the black wolf figure is on the card, it heals 1 HP. Otherwise, it just engages. It's already engaged. It's not going to do anything. Then it would use shadow to actually do a resist attack, but we don't have any shadow anymore. Yes. So we have the last villain card. That means next round, Broderick is coming out. And we have, if the black wolf figure is on the board, it must engage and inflict 6. Oh, man. So it's going to attack Loxley for 6. Loxley has 2 defense for might. Let's roll our 2 dice up, and we get 2 successes plus the 1 armor. That's 3. So he's going to take 3 damage out of the 6 health that he has. That's pretty good. We'll move to the quest turn. All we have to do here is discard a card or remove a progress. We're going to discard Lose the Scent. Not that I want to do that, but we've got to. We have our Burning Altar. Each hero may suffer 1 damage to change 1 altar die to a result of their choice. I think I might have Layson do that. Layson's going to take 1 point of damage. That's the 3rd one to change this water into a shadow. Because I'm potentially going to go back to werewolf form. We'll see. Then, unfortunately, there is fire out here. So it says each figure must either discard 1 armor token or suffer 1 damage. Both of our characters have an armor that they can each discard. However, Loxley does not have an armor, so Loxley will take his 4th point of damage. And then the Black Wolf, which has fully healed, will now take 1 point of damage again. He has 9 health remaining. Finally, we do have Gwendol adjacent to the crates, so a hero adjacent to this feature may gain 1 supply. That will be our 7th supply. We'll reroll our altar die, and we have some wind. That's great. To start off our hero turn, let's start off with Layson. Layson's going to move 1, 2, 3 right up and personal on this werewolf. Then let's interrogate that black wolf. We only need 2 more successes, you guys. Only 2 more. So we have a clever trap. We're going to be testing our agility. Our agility is 2. We're most definitely going to use 1 of our 7 supply to make it 3. We have to place this quest token onto the black wolf. We'll roll 3 dice. 1, 2, and thank goodness. We have, oh wait, actually I don't need that. 5, 6, 7, 8. I only need 2. So I'll gain another focus. So that'll give me 2 focus in total. Those 2 will be just enough to complete the unnatural protection. That means that Broderick will not have +2 defense. I'm then going to play a feat on myself. I'm going to test my willpower, which is 2. For each success, choose a hero within range to heal 1 damage or gain 1 focus. Then we do have some wind here, so I think I'm going to use that as well. Choose a hero within range to heal 1 damage and draw a card. So we're definitely going to do that. We'll do that second. We got to do this part first. Let's roll our 2 dice and that altar die. And we have 2 successes. So for each success, we can either heal a damage. Let's heal 2 damage. So we're going to heal 2 damage with that one. Then, because we're using wind, and hey, we rolled another wind. That's awesome. We can choose a hero within range to heal 1 damage and draw 1 card. So we're going to draw another card. And we have Loon's Elusive Grace. We could use that again soon. And we're going to heal another point of damage. Beautiful. For our third action, we're just going to use our ranger bow here. So we're just going to attack for a total of 2, because that's what our agility is. And we're going to attack the black wolf. I mean, there isn't really any advantage of attacking him, except for maybe we can get some more focus. Let's see, just looking for focus, really. We got a burst there and a success, so we'll roll for the burst. We'll gain 1 focus, that gives us 3 total focus. And we did, with 3 points of damage, we did 2 damage to him. Awesome, so he has 8 health left. Actually, that's not right. We had 1 damage on him before, so with 2 damage, he has 7 health left. For Gwendol, I think the first thing we're going to do is use a light to gain a 3rd focus, and we're going to use a fire here to have Loxley move and attack. Loxley is attacking with 2 dice. Let's see what we get. We get 2 successes, so that's going to be 1 more point of damage. That's 4 to the black wolf. We've got another fire and a water. Still no action yet has been done, and I think I'm going to use wind here to have each of us heal 1 point of damage. We'll reroll that up. I think then, yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do yet. We'll reroll that die up, and we get another shadow. And you know what? Because of that, I'm going to use my Crescent of the Loon here, exhaust it, to reroll up to 2 altar dice. I don't like that shadow and the other shadow. So we're going to take both shadow and reroll them. Come on, wind or something. Oh, I got a shadow again. And we've got more fire. For my first action then, I think I'm going to move 1, 2, 3. I'm within range 2. I'm going to whack him with my oak staff. We'll roll 2 dice for this attack. We're just doing the basic attack here. And we get 2 successes. We did 1 point of damage to him. And we're going to gain our 4th focus token. I'll take that. For my last action, I think I'm just going to draw a card for Gwendol. Gwendol's going to get the Predator's Instincts. And then we're going to have each of us draw a card. We have Nature's Fury. That's a great card. And Layson's going to grab the Harrowing Howl. Oh, this is a new one you haven't seen. We're also going to discard our Potion of Healing, and we're going to heal ourselves up to full. We'll move to that villain turn. First thing that happens is if the Black Wolf figure is on its card, it heals. It's not, but it's going to use the shadow here to have him heal 2 damage. Okay, then I'll have to roll this. If the Black Wolf figure is on its card, it's not, it heals 1 HP. Otherwise, it engages, it already engages. And if I roll this as a shadow, it's going to do the resist effect. Here's to hoping this does not happen. No, we've got more water. Now what happens, since we have no cards in the villain deck, we have to flip his villain card. And he's going to come out with 20 HP and 2 armor. Thank goodness it's not 4 HP and 24, or 4 defense and 24 HP. That's what it would have been. We have, when this enemy spawns, remove the Black Wolf card and figure from the game. So I'll remove the Black Wolf because he basically appears to us as this. And we go, oh my gosh, we've been fighting him the whole freaking time. And he is going to do his activate effect. Now you can see his range is 1. He can move up to 5. He has engage. Well, he's already engaged with Loxley. If unable, engage and inflict. He's going to inflict 7. And Loxley's defense is 2 for agility. Now, fortunately, we have no light here, so he's not going to gain any armor tokens. So he's simply going to appear right here and attack Loxley. Loxley will roll his 2 dice that he has here. He gets 2 total successes. He has 1 armor, that's 3, so he takes 4 points of damage. He's toast. He had 3 damage on him already, so he's going to be placed back on his card. But you see how awesome Loxley is? He's taken so much damage for us. We'll move to the quest phase. The active hero with the advantage card in their threat area, none of us do. If there are no advantage cards in play, draw a villain card. There aren't any left. So then we just have this one. Each hero may suffer 1 damage to change 1 alter die to their choice. Absolutely, I'm going to do that. I'm going to have Gwendol take 1 damage, and I'm going to have Layson do that. Layson's going to grab a shadow, and we're going to change a water into a shadow. And then Gwendol's going to change a water into a wind because we want to be able to get Loxley back out. Then, because there's fire here, we also have each figure must either discard 1 armor token or suffer 1 damage. Gwendol still has 2 armor tokens, so she'll remove 1. Layson has none, so she'll take a point of damage. Broderick is there. He's going to take 1 point of damage. He's down to 19 health. And I think we're ready to roll that up and then start the next round. We're going to hammer on this guy. Let's give this die a roll, and we've got some light. I'm hoping we can take Broderick out right here. We might be able to do it. We'll see. I'm going to go ahead and use our wind here to start. You and Loxley may each heal 1 damage, and then we can place Loxley out on the board. We'll roll this up, and we get a fire. The wolf thinks he's taken out Loxley, and Loxley says, I'm back. Then we're going to do a fun little combo here. We're going to have Gwendol spend her first action doing At My Command. She is going to attack at a range of 4 using her charisma. That's going to be 2 dice. Using a supply, though, that'll be 3 dice. Beautiful. Then it says it has to be an enemy adjacent to Loxley. If Loxley is within range, reduce that target's defense by 1. So Broderick only has 1 defense for this attack. Then we have Spot Weakness here that we're going to play as a reaction. Play this card before a hero within range rolls dice for an attack. Discard 1 armor token from that target, and the hero adds 1 burst to that result. So sweet. We're also going to use the light here to have each hero within range gain 1 focus. So that means Gwendol has a total of 5 focus, and Layson has 3. Let's give our dice a roll, and we've got 1 burst there. Plus, I'm going to place another burst out thanks to that reaction card. So we get to roll 2 more dice in for this. So I give both of these a roll. Okay, so we have a total of 1. I'm going to use a focus here. 1, 2, 3. We'll use a focus for this one. 4, 5, 6, 7 damage. 7 damage minus the 1 armor. That's 6 damage to him. He already had 1 damage on him. He has 7 damage on him now. Then the next card we're going to play is Nature's Fury. We're going to attack with our willpower at a range of 4. We're going to use a supply, so we get to roll 4 dice for this instead of 3. And Loxley is within range, so we can change 1 alter die to a color of our choice or a type of our choice. We're definitely going to change this one to an earth, so we can use that to do an automatic damage to an enemy in range, which will be Broderick. So Broderick has 8 points of damage on him. So I'm going to roll 4 dice for this. I am going to reroll that ultra die right now, but he now has 2 defense instead of 1 for this attack. So let's give him a roll. We have 2 bursts here. That's pretty sweet. Gosh, look at all this fire I'm getting. 2 bursts means we get to roll 2 more dice, and we've got 2 more successes. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to use 2 more of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 total hits. -2 is 5. So that's 5 damage that he has. That means he's down to 7 health. Can our werewolf do 7 points of damage? I'm thinking that might be the case. Next, I think I'm going to have Loxley exhaust. He's not going to move, but he's going to use the fire here to attack. He only gets to roll 2 dice, but even if he gets 1 burst, so he can roll 1 more die and gets another success, hits another point of damage. So let's try it. We're rolling 2 dice and that alter die we used, and we get a burst. I'm telling you, this cat is ridiculous. And we get another hit. So we did 1, 2, 3 points of damage. He's got 2 armor, so he'll take 1 point of damage. That means he only has 6 health left. Thank you, Loxley. We still have one more action as Gwendol. Gwendol's within range 2 of Broderick. Let's use her oak staff and bonk him on the head. Let's see if we can knock some sense into him. Rolling 2 dice. We have a burst. Let's see. That will go beautiful. I have 1 focus here that I can use. 1, 2, 3 total successes. He's got 2 armor. He now only has 5 health remaining. And I should mention, with this die, I get that focus back. All right, I think it's time for Layson to deal the final blow. The first thing Layson is going to do is use his Ranger Bow. He's going to exhaust this card and deal 1 damage to an enemy within range. So he's going to go ahead and deal 1 damage to Broderick. Broderick now needs 4 more damage and he's toast. We're then going to use this Shadow Die. We're going to take a point of damage and we're going to flip over to Werewolf form. Now that we're in werewolf form, let's take him out with what he tries to be. We're going to use our fortitude. Our fortitude is 3 for Layson. We're going to attack, and look at this, this is within a range of 3. That's so cool. This attack targets each enemy within range. I'm going to reroll these 2 dice with this attack. If we get some wind, we can also have each hero within range gain 1 focus. Let's see it, Layson. Let's see you take on Broderick. We, of course, are going to be using a supply for this as well, so we're going to roll 4 dice and the 2 altar dice that we used. Let's see what we get. Well, that's not as great as I was hoping. We do have a shadow, actually. That is awesome. We have here, after rolling dice for your attack, add 1 burst to the result. We can do that because we have a shadow here, so I'm going to add the burst as a success, and we get to roll another die. We'll roll those in, and we get another burst. Let's roll that in here, and we get another success. Is this enough? We need 7 successes to take him out. No, actually, how many do we need? Actually, only 6. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep, toast. We just took him out with a howling howl. We showed him what a real werewolf was like. Well, there you have it, folks. That was Alter Quest. We did the showdown scenario using 2 really fun heroes. I hope you guys enjoyed the playthrough. I have to say, this game is fun. It is not short, so do not play this if you don't have a lot of time. This is going to take you a lot of time to play. But I feel like all of the reactions and the feat cards and the use of the altar dice, both for you and the enemies, it's so cool. I love these features and how each one does different things. I love that I can just lay this out on the table and start playing. I don't have to build a map with tons of tiles or try and find tiles in the middle of the game. It's so easy to find features. I just have them on the table, pull them out. The miniatures are super good quality. I mean, way better than what I saw when I played Street Masters. I like them a lot. I feel like they are definitely better. And although I do feel like there are a lot of corner cases in the game, how things work, I feel like once you start playing it and you've played it at least 2 or 3 times, it's going to flow much better. So, and there's so many things with this that are modular, which is great. You can have different quests with different villains, with different threats. And I love that. And then play with different heroes. It does mean that sometimes you'll have really hard scenarios, or you might have really easy scenarios. So watch that. But overall, I still really enjoy it. I'm definitely going to do another playthrough soon. I haven't decided if I'm going to show you the campaign or what I'm going to do. Let me know what you'd like to see for Alter Quest, because there's no question I'm going to get this onto the table again. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you at the next stop.